Selfish Giant is a beautiful fictitious story written by Oscar Wilde. This story revolves around a play garden which becomes lavish in the presence of children and dries in the absence of children. This story teaches us to treat kids in the right way. Now let's start the story in detail. The giant's garden was beautiful and children loved to play in it. The giant, who was selfish, built a high wall round his lovely garden. Children did not enter the garden thereafter, nor did spring and summer till the giant experienced a change of heart. Every afternoon, as they are coming from school, the children used to go and play in the giant's garden. It was a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees that in the springtime broke out into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. The birds sat on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. "How happy we are here," they cried to each other. One day, the giant came back. He had been to visit his friend, the Cornish ogre, and had stayed with him for 7 years. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in the garden. "What are you doing here?" he cried in a very gruff voice, and the children ran away. In the beginning of the lesson, we can see a giant's garden, a very beautiful garden. And the specialty of this garden is that the children who are coming from the school used to play in this giant's garden. It was a very large and lovely garden with soft green grass, and we can see even the beautiful flowers that are just popping like the stars. And there were 12 peach trees. During the springtime, these peach trees were full of pink and pearl blossoms, the flowers. And during the autumn, this trees used to give the sweet and delicate peach. And the birds used to sit on the trees and they used to sing so sweetly that the children used to stop their game in order to listen to this music. And they were so happy to be inside the giant's garden. But one day what happened, the giant came back. Actually, he had gone to visit his friend who was living in the UK. His friend was an ogre. Ogre means a cruel giant who eats people. And the selfish giant, or the giant owner of this garden, was there with him for 7 years. But when he came back, when he saw the children playing in the garden, he all of a sudden got irritated, angry, and in a very gruff voice, very rough voice, he just shouted at the kids, "What are you doing here? What are you doing here?" he cried in a very gruff voice, and the children ran away. "My own garden is my own garden," said the giant. "Anyone can understand that, and I'll allow nobody to play in it but myself." So he built a high wall all around and put up a notice board: "Trespassers will be prosecuted." Now we can understand the cruelty or the selfishness of the giant. He doesn't want anybody to be inside his garden. He doesn't want anybody to be entertained in his garden. He made a notice board over there that trespassers will be prosecuted. Means those who are entering somebody's property, those who are entering his property will be punished. That is a board he put up over there. He was a very selfish giant. The poor children had now nowhere to play. They tried to play on the road, but the road was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they did not like it. They used to wander around the high walls where their lessons were over and talk about the beautiful garden inside. "How happy we were there," they said to each other. Then the spring came, and all over the country there was little blossom and little birds. Only in the garden of the selfish giant it was still winter. The birds did not care to sing in it as there were no children and the trees forget to blossom. By seeing the notice put up by Giant, we can understand how selfish he was. And now the poor children had no place to play. And they tried to play on the road, but the condition of the road was very pathetic. It was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they were not feeling happy to play on the road. What they used to do, they used to wander around the high walls, around the beautiful garden, and they used to remind or they used to recollect the memories inside the beautiful garden. And during this time, the spring season started, and all over the country we can see the blossoms and little birds. But only in the garden of the selfish giant, it was still winter, and the birds were not willing to sing as there were no children, and even the trees forget to bloom, they forget to blossom. Once a beautiful flower put its head out from the grass, but when it saw the notice board, it was so sorry for the children that it slipped back into the ground again and went off to sleep. The only people who were pleased were the snow and the frost. "Spring has forgotten this garden," they cried, "so we will live here all the year round." The snow covered up the grass with her great white cloak, and the frost painted all the trees silver. Then they invited the north wind to stay with them, and he came. He was wrapped in furs, and he rode all day about the garden and blew the chimney pots down. "This is a delightful spot," he said. "We must ask hail on a visit." So the hail came. Every day for 3 hours he rattled on the roof of the castle till he broke most of the slates, and then he ran round and round the garden as fast as he could go. He was dressed in grey and his breath was like ice. Here we can see that except in the giant's garden, everywhere else they were celebrating spring season. But in giant's garden we can see the presence of winter still prevailing, in the form of snow, frost, hailstorm and even north wind. Just because of the absence of the kids in the garden, just because of the happiness of them, just because of the selfishness of the giant, the winter season was still prevailing over there. And all over the garden was just covered with the white cloak of the snowfall, and the frost painted all the trees silver. And they even invited the north wind to stay with them. The snow and the frost invited the north wind to stay with them. And he was wrapped, the north wind was wrapped in furs, and he was roaring all day long in the garden and even blew the chimney pots down. For them it was a very delightful spot, very happy spot. And they thought that they will even ask hail to come for a visit. And the hail too came, and for every single day, 3 hours, the hailstorm used to rattle on the roof of the castle, and it was good enough to break most of the slates of the castle. And even hailstorm was dressed in grey, and even his breath was like ice. "I cannot understand why the spring is so late in coming," said the selfish giant, as he sat at the window and looked out at his cold, white garden. "I hope there will be a change in the weather." But the spring never came, nor the summer. The autumn gave golden fruit to every garden, but to the giant's garden she gave none. "He's too selfish," she said. So it was always winter there, and the north wind and the hail and the frost and the snow danced about through the trees. Here we can see that actually the selfish giant is worried why the spring season is so late in his garden, and he was just sitting beside his window and looking out and hoping that soon there will be a change in the weather, but it doesn't happen. He missed spring, summer and autumn. Everyone denied to be there. For the autumn, they thought that selfish giant is so cruel, so selfish, so she denied to be over there. And only the winter was there, along with north wind, hail and the frost and the snow. They were just having a splendid time in the selfish giant's garden. One morning the giant was lying awake in bed when he heard some lovely music. It sounded so sweet to his ears that he thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. It was really only a little linnet singing outside his window, but it was so long since he had heard a bird singing in his garden that it seemed to him to be the most beautiful music in the world. Then the hail stopped dancing over his head and the north wind ceased roaring and a delicious perfume came to him through the open casement. "I believe the spring has come at last," said the giant, and he jumped out of the bed and looked out. In this paragraph, we can see a change in the scenario of the selfish giant's garden. One morning, the giant was laying awake in his bed and he heard some lovely music. It was so sweet to his ears and he thought that it must be the king's musician passing by. But it was really the music made by a little bird, Linnet, and it was just singing outside his window. And it was a very long time he heard a bird singing in this garden, and it seemed to be the most beautiful music in the world. Then that time the hail stopped dancing over his head and the north wind even stopped roaring and the delicious perfume of the flowers came through his open casement, and he thought that at last the spring has reached his garden, and the giant, he just jumped out of the bed and looked out.